Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. Let's solve the problem binary search tree iterator. So we have to implement BST iterator class such that the iterator over this is in order traversal of our binary search tree. And this class has one constructor where we will get the root node of our tree and has next method. We have to return true if there exists a number of in traversal to the right of the pointer, otherwise return false. And int, another method is next method, which is return int the value of the node at that point. Like when the iterator reach at particular point, we have to return the value of that node. So so this is our tree. So let's understand this over here. So we have to, first solution is like very straightforward, like naively what we can do, as we have to generate the in order tree iterator. So what we will do, from the root node in the constructor method itself of our BST iterator class, we will iterate this root tree and find out the in order traversal and store in any like list data structure. So we iterate it and store all the node values in our list. So we iterate, so if we build the iterate through it, and in order traversal of this tree will be like 3, 7, 9, 15, and 20. So once we got the in order traversal, now we can have two options. We can use the inbuilt tag Java iterator from the list. So list.iterator, we will use the iterator object, create a global object and define it as let's say this name is list. So we will get the iterator from the list.iterator. So once we got the iterator, then thereafter we just need to use the inbuilt iterator from the class. And here in the method, like next, we just call iterator.next, and in this method we just call iterator, we will just return the iterator has next. So this will be solved by this approach. But with this approach, as you can see, we are storing all the node values in the list. So this will take O of n time as well as O of n space, because O of n time is we are iterating all the nodes. So this is the one solution we can come up with the so let's see if we can further optimize it. So what, as we have to do in order traversal, so what we will do from the root. So in the follow up problem, we have to come up with this, like could you implement next and has O1 and the use OH space. So how we can save the memory? So what we will do, we just go to push all the left node from the current node. So here when we start from root, we will store all the node in the stack. So let's we go, first we will add this node 7 and then we add the node 3, and once we reach to null, then it is the last. So if you see in the in order, the leftmost node, the first minimum node is our the leftmost node. And here what we will do, so this is the first in the constructor we will call, and now in the next method what we do, we will pick this element as a temporary node. So we will get the node 3 as a temporary node. Now this is our the current next node. So what we will do, we will check if this node further has the right subtree. If there is a right subtree, we will again call the and method, like we will call that method which will add all the left node, push left method. So push all the left nodes of the node we are passing. So we will call this method for root node dot right, and this will add. But for this now, 3 is not having any right node, so we will just keep continue it, and we will return the value of this node in our next method. While in has next method, we just check the always the size of our stack. If the size is not empty, then the hasNext has to return true, otherwise hasNext has to return 5. So first, let's say for this example, we are calling next, this will return 3 as it is here. This will return 3 first, then we are calling again next, so we will get the 7, and 7 has the right subtree. So we need to add all the nodes from right dot 7 dot right, which is this, and all the left node of this, so left of this. So we will add here in our list, first this will go get out, this also get out. Now the next node will 15 will come in, and then 9, and we will return 7 as the output. After that, we are checking hasness. So our stack is has still a node, so we have to return true here. And then we are calling next. So in this next, we will again get the node 9. And for 9, there is no write, so we just return the 9 and continue it. Similarly, we are calling hasNet, and this stack still have one element, so we have to return true. And now we are calling again next. So this is 15. We will return 15, and 15 has write subtree, so we need to add 20 in the stack. And then we next we return 20, and the hasNext will become now false. So there is no. So this is how the way we will solve just in the, so the maximum storage we are using here is a height of the tree. At any moment there will be O of H node in our stack. So let's implement this solution. So for implementation, we will use a stack. So stack, we will add the tree node itself here, and this is, let's say, stack, and this we will initialize the stack in our constructor, new stack. Once we initialize the this in constructor, we will call the pushLeft method. So that will add all the left subtree node. So that's it. So here let's write up this method. So let's do it in the bottom, as it is always good practice to write all the private method in the end of the class, so that this will be abstracted from the out of this class. So private void and pushLeft. This will get the tree node, let's say root, and we will keep at this in the while the root is not null, and keep at the node in the stack, stack dot add root, and update root y, root equal to root dot left. So that's it. This is the method definition and implementation of pushLeft method in hasNext. Now we need to first get the tree node, temp node from the stack dot pop. Once we got this, we will again check the if this current node has right subtree, so right child. If not, then we will call the pushLeft method for node dot right. And in the end we return node dot value. So that's it for the next method. For the hasNext method, we just return if stack dot size is greater than or 0. If it is, then there is a some element. So let's compile this and see. There is a cannot find symbol. Stack, I guess some typo, yeah. So this is the stack typo. So it is working now, and we are getting expected answer. So now let's submit this code, and it is accepted. So now let's discuss about the time and space complexity. So as you can see, the there will be O of H maximum node in our stack. So the space of this solution is O of H, and the previous solution is taking O of N, where we are storing all the nodes. And the time complexity, let's discuss all the time complexity. So in the constructor, this will call this all at the push dot left node. In the next method, this is we are reading the node, which is O of one operation from the stack, removing that pop element. And but this is also we are calling pushLeft method. So this can go in worst case O of N as well. But in amortized case, there will be this is also O of 1. So if you like this solution, hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching.